Good evening, you're watching To The Point. I'm Preeti Chaudhary. So of late, we've seen a concerted attempt by the Congress, especially the Congress President Rahul Gandhi, to paint the RSS as the villain, wherein the attack is not so much on the present-day government, but to what the Congress feels holds the remote to the government, the Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh.
Congress party mein aur BJP mein farak kya main aapko batata hu. बस चलती है, कांग्रेस पार्टी लोगों को बस में डालती है और फिर बस की चाबी जनता को दे देती है और कहती है भैया देखो चलाओ. बीजेपी की बस में, बीजेपी के लोगों को बस में बैठाती है, कहती है भैया तुम लोग चुप हो, एक शब्द मत बोलो, और आरएसएस बस को चलाती है.
But now wait a minute. It seems the Congress has taken a direct leaf of its biggest adversary, the RSS. Aiming to regain its weakened contact at the grassroots, the Congress has started rebuilding one of its oldest institutions, an institution which is on its last legs, possibly defunct, the Seva Dal, which was once served as a bulwark to combat the colonial Raj. Now, the Seva Dal was a frontal grassroots organization of the Congress, which came about in 1924, years before the RSS. The purpose was to counter the colonial Raj in 1931. Now, what is the Congress Seva Dal game plan? Is to host flags in 1,000 cities every month to take a cue out of the RSS where nationalism and patriotic pride is concerned. One of the primary objectives of the reformed Congress Seva Dal would be to challenge the hegemony that the RSS and the BJP have acquired on the narrative of nationalism and patriotism, where the Congress is seemingly reaching out for the hyper-nationalist tag, but what seemed to be till now the preserve of the RSS and the BJP. Case in point, the reformed RSS will hoist every month, like we pointed out, the Indian national flag in 1,000 cities. On your television screens, you see, of course, that is Nehru of the Seva Dal. He founded the Seva Dal.
के जरिए पूरे देश भर में गेरुआ, दोरंगा और तिरंगा जो है उसका क्या फर्क है वो लेके जनता के बीच में जाएंगे. एक का काम है लोगों को तोड़ना, दूसरे का काम जोड़ने का. एक जहर फैलाता है, हम रूत फैलाते हैं. एक आसियाना जो है तोड़ते हैं, हम आसियाना बसाते हैं. एक जलाने का काम करते हैं, हम वो आग बुझाने का काम करते हैं. ये बात लेके कार्यकर्ता गांव में जाएगा.
So that was Lalji Desai, the new president of the Seva Dal put forth by the Congress. The fact being that the Seva Dal is an organization older than the RSS, was formed by Pandit Nehru. We just showed you those pictures there. Main agenda of the Seva Dal was to take on the Britishers, colonial Raj. However, the new agenda is nation building. But the sticking point is, how is it that the Congress has suddenly realized the need of a splinter group to espouse the virtues of patriotism and nationalism?
आरएसएस तो सरकारी संसाधनों पर टिका हुआ संगठन है और कॉरपोरेट के संसाधनों पर टिका हुआ संगठन है. आरएसएस जनता के टैक्स के पैसे गलत कामों में इस्तेमाल करता है, तो उनकी और हमारी कंपैरिजन नहीं हो सकती. हम लोग जो हैं हमारे अपने बलबूते पर, अपने पैरों पर खड़े हैं. हम समाज के अलग अलग कंट्रीब्यूशन से हमारा सेवा दल का काम चलता है.
गाँव में या नदी में कोई नया आदमी जब जाता है जी, डूबते रहता है तो हाथ पैर जो मारता है, वही हालात कांग्रेस पार्टी के नेता राहुल जी का हाथ पर मार रहे हैं, मगर कोई फायदा नहीं है, डूबना तय है, कोई नहीं बचा सकता है.
So what is it that the Congress has suddenly come to discover its old defunct organization, the Seva Dal, to revive that? Why is the Congress doing so? Questions we are putting forth and To The Point this evening. Can the Seva Dal counter the Sangh hegemony over nationalism? Well, that is what the intention is, but can it do so? Can a Seva Dal help Congress match RSS boots on ground when it comes to elections? Because ultimately, it is the RSS that has made the BJP win elections. Can a Seva Dal, which has absolutely no cadre to talk about, do so? Now, Hindutva holds the RSS cadre together. That is the glue. What will be the glue that binds the Seva Dal? It was fighting the colonial Raj. That's not there anymore. What are people going to unite under? And lastly, after years of neglect, is the Congress now trying to ape the BJP and the RSS to try and revive the Seva Dal? All right, I want to connect to our guest. We have R.P. Singh, Bharatiya Janata spokesperson. Sanjay Jha from the Congress will be joining us in just a short while from now. We have Sanjeev Unayal, RSS supporter. We have Javed Ansari, senior journalist, who's in the studio with me. R.P. Singh, why is the BJP so skeptical of this revival of the Seva Dal? What's wrong with the Congress going back to one of its grassroots organizations and trying to resurrect it?
Why do you think that we are skeptical? I mean, they are free to do what they want to do. There is a political outfit and they can do. I mean, BJP is a political outfit. We as a party can do what we want to do. Congress, a political outfit, can think what they want to do. They want to create a Seva Dal, Meva Dal, whatever dal they want to create. Well, their party is a Meva Dal. Now they want to create a Seva Dal. Let them do that. And then it is nothing to do with RSS. RSS and BJP are two entities, different entities altogether. If there's some comparison between the two, I'm sorry for that.
They might be two different entities, but R.P. Singh, you're actually telling me that the RSS doesn't help you win elections, they're not your boots on ground? That your ideology doesn't stem from the RSS? Are you actually going to say that?
No. I'm not denying that our ideology...
Then how are you two different groups?
Can I give
ideologically cut off the same fabric?
Please, I am saying so. But RSS never tells its cadre to work for a political party or not. I mean, they have never... If I am part of RSS, I have never been told that you to work for a political party.
But you are...
No. I am, but there are people
right.
Who will work for other parties also. In my local area, I know a person who goes to Shaka every day, but still works for some other party. And that party has no problem for that person working in the with that party and then being part of the RSS Shaka also.
You know, so all right. Okay, you know, Mr. Singh, just stay on with us. As we wait for Sanjay Jha, I'll bring in Javed Ansari. Those visuals that we're showing you right there are today's visuals. They're of Rahul Gandhi at the Seva Dal meeting. That white cap you see is supposed to be now a distinction made from the RSS. The RSS has a black cap, the Seva Dal will have the white cap. Javed, you know, what is this strange urgency of the Congress now to rediscover the Seva Dal and especially to, you know, make it function? Look at the kind of, you know, the programs that they have lined up. To hoist the national flag once a month, to every cadre should know the national anthem. Do you think somewhere down the line they're trying to ape what the Bharatiya Janata Party and the RSS is doing? And they do somewhere down the line do have the hegemony, especially where hyper-nationalism comes into play.
I don't think they're trying to ape. What they're trying to do is blunt the BJP and the RSS attack. They have a mountain to climb. It's a no-brainer. The RSS organization, the RSS cadre, are miles ahead. It will take years for the Seva Dal to come in contention, leave alone matching the RSS. Having said that, this is an attempt, this is a part of an attempt to try and rev up the organization, to get there the moribund Congress organization, which was once very mighty, which was once found in every village of this country, almost, so to say. Now it's moribund, to get it up and running. Like I said, it will take a mountain to climb. They are trying to undercut, blunt the RSS attack. So therefore, it's two prongs. Earlier, the RSS used to accuse the Congress of being soft on Hindu. Rahul Gandhi started temple hopping. Now, as far as the nationalism plank is concerned, this is a part of their program that the Seva Dal will go to villages and
okay.
Hoist flags and all that. Whether they cut sides, whether this is taken on board by the people or not, in time for the 2019 elections, I'm not too sure.
Sanjeev Unayal, as somebody who's a strong supporter of the RSS, do you think the Seva Dal would be able to cut any ice when it comes down to what at least the RSS would like to stand for, a certain style of patriotism and nationalism?
You know that what is philosophically, I'll be telling you exactly what is going on. To see the basic names of the with this particular party, Congress Seva Dal. So some Seva Dal might be coming from the Congress itself. But on the contrary, if you see Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, it is something different. BJP is a political small part of a big RSS.
But Mr. Unayal, it's not
so
Congress Seva Dal. No, I'd like to correct you.
You cannot differentiate.
Sir, I'd like to correct you.
You cannot say it.
Sir, so, I'd like to correct you. It's not Congress Seva Dal, it is
yes.
Seva Dal. Like it is RSS, this is also
yes,
Seva Dal.
Previously, it was Congress Seva Dal. If you do the investigation, they might have changed the name. Because number of times at the time of the Nehru, they have launched this particular Seva Dal. Might be Congress Seva Dal, or because that is coming out of a political party. But on the contrary, whatever you are saying, you can choose. Again, I am saying Rashtriya Sam Sevak Sangh has got 50-60 Anusangik Sangathan. So a political wing of Rashtriya Sam Sevak Sangh is BJP. Bharatiya Janata Party. But on the contrary, Congress is coming out giving a new birth to a Seva Dal which had been died long before. They have given so much respiration.
No, fair enough. That's the point. And Sanjay Jha, you're trying to discover an organization. Yes.
Dedicated team of forces like a Sam Sevak Sangh.
Right, okay. Mr. Unnial, fair point. Sanjay Jha, you're trying to revive, resurrect an organization which, of course, was launched before the RSS, 1924. But it's on its last legs now. You have absolutely no cadre. How is it that the Congress has suddenly discovered the Seva Dal?
You know, Preeti, I don't think anybody in our country had anticipated that if Narendra Modi becomes Prime Minister, you will find pseudo-nationalism, hyper-nationalism, communal propaganda, the whole idea of India being distorted. And, you know, end of day, if you look at the RSS event in Nagpur the other day, they did not even play the national flag or the national anthem. I think that is an insult to the entire
Sanjay, if you're talking about hyper-nationalism,
where the Seva Dal Lalit Desai, anybody who knows the history of the Seva
Sanjay,
Dal.
Sanjay, if you're going to talk about hyper-nationalism, Lalit Desai, the president now of Seva Dal, has just released over the next 1 month on what the Seva Dal is actually going to be doing, and it's rather interesting. Mm-hmm. So you're going to be hoisting the flag every month in 1,000 cities. Sure. Every village you will be going and singing the national anthem once a week. Is this not hyper-nationalism somewhere down the line, Sanjay?
Right.
We have to prove themselves as a nationalist. That's the problem.
And I can actually read a lot more, but yes.
Unlike the BJP and the RSS and the Jansang. No. Let me answer this.
Sanjay, you have to prove because you have created a Seva Dal because till now.
Please ask him.
RP Singh, I'll come to you. Let's have a civil debate. We have a lot of time. Let's have a civil debate. Sanjay, make your point.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, Preeti, let me tell you. The Jansang, the RSS and the Hindu Mahasabha had no contribution to our freedom struggle. They have actually no contribution to our fight against the British. They were on the side of the British. And they did not even care for India's Quit India movement.
I'm sorry, you are poor at history, sir.
They claim to be the nationalists of this country. They are going to give lectures on patriotism. Anyway, let me answer the question, Preeti, and please stop him from interrupting me. I think what is going to happen is not just flag hoisting. We're going to talk to the people of our country on the true nationalism, which is not based on Hindutva nationalism. We're going to talk about secularism. We're going to talk about the multicultural plurality of this country. We will make the discourse what it should be, telling people what India is all about.
Will you talk about diversity, also?
The fact that we are a unique country.
No, 1 second, can we come down?
Unlike the BJP, unlike the RSS, who are monochromatic and who want to impose a certain, what I call is a very regressive, orthodox, and a great number of ways of the Hitler and the Nazi kind of fascist ideology in our country. We don't want that to happen.
How have you forgotten an emergency, sir?
A plurality and a complexion where we embrace everybody.
Who was Nazi and who was Hitler?
And therefore,
emergency?
They are nervous. Therefore, the BJP and the RSS are nervous.
All right, one second. Javed, I'd like to bring you in. Now, is this the call of the day? Is the Congress practically pushed into a corner? Not much elbow room. I'll come to you, Mr. Singh. So not much political elbow room, needs to contest the RSS and is doing so with the Seva Dal. But when you come down to the brass tacks of it, will the Seva Dal be able to match the boots on ground when it comes to an election?
This election, certainly no, because the BJP and the RSS is far better organized, much better trained. They've been at it for decades. The Seva Dal is now waking up from its slumber. So if your question pertains to this election, far from it.
All right. One question I'd like to ask you, Sanjay, before we go to Sanjeev Unnial, and I'll come to you, RP Singh. What is it that is actually going to hold together this outfit of yours, which is actually on its last legs. Now, there's Hindutva, which is the bottom line when it comes to the RSS. For the Seva Dal, it was the Britishers, the fight against the Britishers. That's not there anymore.
You know, Preeti, the truth is that the Congress party has got tremendous grassroots presence. Now, what has happened over the years is that, you
it
know,
would have reflected
day,
in elections, Sanjay. It's never,
we needed
so let's
to
not,
reinvigorate
yeah, let's
these
not
organizations
on
a lot
account.
More. No, 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 we are not kidding ourselves at all. I'm glad you're asking me this question and answer you with complete honesty. I think the kind of penetration we have in every nook or every village of India is phenomenal. What has happened perhaps over the last couple of decades is that we have allowed a degree of a gap to happen between the reaching the people in the last mile and the capabilities of not just the Congress party, the Mahila Congress, you have the NSUI, we have the Indian Youth Congress, and you have the Seva Dal. I think we need to galvanize all of it into a greater force. Rahul Gandhi has become the president of the party, you can see the manifestations of change.
Sanjay, but you don't have it. You know what I'd like
no,
to quote is,
no, this is not just on paper.
During
you know,
the Karnataka elections,
hundreds of Congress functions.
During the Karnataka elections and even
no,
before,
but,
so many interviews of Amit
right,
Shah.
Right.
And it's interesting.
No,
and I'd like to bring R.P. Singh there. It's interesting because he would always say that I'm not so bothered about the leaders, but I'm bothered about the Seva Dal cadre because they are working and I want them to come in. The defection from Seva Dal to the RSS and the BJP has been huge. And you know that. R.P. Singh, do you think the Congress is somewhere trying to ape the BJP and the RSS here?
See, they can't ape us, one. Secondly, we have a different style of functioning. They have a different
well,
style
we
of functioning.
It's
a dynasty. Is a dynasty owned company. We are a democratic party. These are two different things. And also, they can bring any Seva Dal or anything. But ultimately, underlining line
funny.
Is that they are a Meva Dal.
Saying, don't be
the
funny.
Complete Congress party is a Meva Dal. They only work for making money and corruption. That's all. So they can keep changing names, they can keep whatever brand they want to brand it like. But heart ko, arre sir, hum nahi ghabra rahe sir, aapse kaun ghabrata hai? 21 pradeshon mein chunav haar chuke hain, aapse ghabrane ki baat karte hain. Aap abhi bhi back door MP hain, wahan pe bhi aapki sarkar khada rahi hai. Karnataka mein aapki sarkar ladkhada rahi hai. Hum nahi bukhla rahe, aap bukhla hue hain. Jo aapne naya naam de diya, ab aapke log niche jaakar, abhi tak upar ke log paisa kamate the, ab niche jaakar mewa kamayenge. Ye hai aapka asli khata.
All right, can we ace? Stick to the debate. It's an English news channel. Let's go with the language.
Then you are Mr. Sanjay Jha to not to bring this typical local dialect into it. And then let's stick to the debate. And the debate is that Seva Dal is basically for them because they are into making business or making money. Now the big bosses make money when they're in mm-hmm. government wherever they are. Now they want to make money at a local level, that's all. I mean, I like to label it as a Meva Dal, not a Seva Dal at all. And Seva Dal mean doing Seva is a very different thing and Congress
okay.
people has never learned to how to do Seva in this country.
All right, let's take last few comments. Sanjeev Punyal, as somebody who's a supporter of the RSS, now one of the key issues that Seva Dal is going to
yes.
follow over the next few months is going to be a recruitment drive. Especially where the RSS is concerned, you look at the charter of the Seva Dal, it actually reflects, if you just take away Hindutva and the Hindu Rashtra bit, it looks exactly like the RSS. So how are you going to dissuade, say, the youth of this country who don't, you know, who want to think what they feel are on secular lines and would want to join an organization which talks about patriotism and nationalism like the RSS?
Preeti, this is a usual process that after 5 years, they come out with a new thing. They want to follow a particular party and point of view. This is a problem. And you see Mr. Sanjay Jha over here also. There is a settled quotation, if you cannot convince, you confuse. Because the topic of Seva Dal has been transformed to different ideological thinking. That was really means now we're concerned with the topic of the today. So first of all, what they come out, Preeti, I'll be telling a very important point to the viewers here.
Okay.
Why they are coming out after going Pranabda in the function of the Nagpur in the 30th verse of the Rashtriya from Sevak Sangh Ward? Why after 2 days they have come out with this particular plan? Because what Pranabda has done over there is itself is an admission that he has gone to a function where idealism, patriotism, nationalism. And
okay.
Rashtrabad ki baat mostly ki jati hai. Aise, he was a person
okay, so
who dictated this all terms in that particular function.
Okay.
He has chosen this particular topic, Pranabda. So that's why Do you think even
aping the BJP or the RSS here could work in favor of the Congress?
One, I don't believe they've just discovered nationalism. This is an organization older than the RSS. Nationalism was there, was core to the agenda even in pre-independence era. So therefore, to claim credit for the RSS or the BJP, to claim credit is highly misplaced. There's no harm if they are taking Pranab Mukherjee's message and going to the villages. Third, as to whether this will bear results in the forthcoming elections, I don't know. It has to be a long drawn process, and just because they don't succeed in the next election doesn't mean they ought to give it up. One of the reasons why the Congress party is where it is because they've ignored frontal organizations and the Congress organization all these years.
All right, so last comment, Sanjay Jha, this neglect over years, when you had an institution in place in 1924 to allow it to completely disseminate and now bring it together, do you think it could work for you?
Well, let me tell you, the big difference is that Seva Dal stands for Indian nationalism. The RSS stands for Hindutva nationalism.
Nobody knew what the Seva Dal stood for today morning when it was back in the news.
They believe in a religious focus.
Rahul Gandhi
stands
for...
No, but I want to make the larger point.
Mr. R.P. Singh, I come to you for a closing comment. Sanjay, quickly make your point.
Exposed before the people of India.
Sir, you are exposed.
RP Singh, give me 10 seconds. The RSS and the BJP are perceptibly nervous.
Okay, so
because
the RSS is
stand exposed. You're going to stand exposed in a very short while. And to answer the question
Sanjay,
of the RSS person,
at this juncture,
this has
one
been
would
a work in progress for a long time.
Just about six hours after you launched the Seva Dal, one would say that is a little presumptuous to say that the RSS is scared. But yes, RP Singh, your quick word in before I close the show.
Only thing is, I'll appreciate, let Sanjay Jha come to one of our shaka for 1 week and understand what nationalism is.
Because he did not let me finish. And because he did not let me finish, I'm going to speak and I'm going to tell
RPC. Okay, I'm going to close the show then. Because this is a debate.
Of our great country.
No, I'm sorry.
We deserve better and India will
So does to the point and so does this debate. I'm forced to close the show if everybody's going to be talking over each other. Thank you for joining us. What's really interesting is the white cap versus the black cap. See the one which Rahul Gandhi was wearing today? Now it's going to be the white cap versus the black cap of the RSS, a rhetoric which is going to be carried on in 2019 as well. Let's see how the Seva Dal works out for the Congress and if there is any consistency to it.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.